starting up the middle, turning over a little to the left. Should find the fairway.
From Australia, please welcome Jason Day.
It's another major champ gets set to go. So that graphic mentioned he was the alternate, did not get in. He said that was one of the longest days he's ever experienced, that wait last year and the disappointment of it. That comes up just shy.
Just tugged it about 5 yards there, Terry.
Marine layer leaving the area. Out to the first. Rickie is third from the bunker. Oh, excellent shot.
Yeah, it's on that upslope right there. You can see him get aggressive, elevated up over that lip. You know, had enough room to work with.
Starts today the way he finished yesterday. In fact, the way he played all day yesterday. Had 10 birdies in the round yesterday. Second tee, Fowler.
A lot of guys playing a fade up here to cut it into the fairway, which is hard from right to left. Fowler's done that. Have to slow the ball down because anything moving right to left there can go into that bunker. Well played there, Rickie Fowler. That'll leave him about 160 yards or so to that pin.
Yeah, this whole location sets up perfectly for a draw. Ball's above his feet. It's a perfect fit. Yeah. Sometimes the whole location is just set up perfect for the
How about this
lie you get. How about that? You know, he said yesterday that he altered his grip pressure a little bit, allows the putter to free up.
In 2011 at Congressional from McIlroy. Fowler off the tee at three.
This could be the biggest, widest fairway in U.S. Open history here. Once you get a 285, it doubles in length as well. But it does camber down to the left-hand side. And the biggest worry the players have with this hole is the divots. Everything goes down into that area. It was fenced off, netted off during the practice round so players wouldn't practice out of there.
Needs just about 1 yard.
Come on now. First three holes for Rickie Fowler off the charts. Dream round yesterday, dream start today for Fowler.
This is well out to the right. This is heading towards the Barranca, right at the bunkers.
Yeah.
Right to left too,
isn't it? I didn't see an overplay. That was really well done.
Yeah, I didn't see him spinning it like that. Long, minus the third hardest hole on the golf course. So
pick a tree, aiming point a la Hogan.
Yeah, there's those palm trees off in the distance. The legend has it that Hogan's caddy told him to aim at the palm trees, and he said, which one?
Of course.
I don't know if it's true.
So see if he's got this dialed in. Two different bounces there, guys.
Just didn't get the hop, did he?
No.
This was while we were away. Rickie Fowler for birdie at the fifth. Dan Hicks, Paul Azinger watching along.
Straight up the hill, and oh boy, look at that go. That's a tester now back down the hill.
The first 21 holes, bogeyed the fourth and trying to not make it two in a row.
Nice. That's so solid. You know, we always remember Rickie for the great putter that he has been.
We're coming into six. I just said, let's lay it up.
It's the way the hole is, it's the way it was meant to be.
Floated up the right, should kick off this slope pretty hard.
A lot of options, even in how far back you leave the ball, or if you want to get it way up there. Ricky's left it reasonably far back.
Really good play off that right side, as Smiley said, just stay out of the land of divots, right?
Yeah, that's a menagerie of divots. You don't want to be in one.
In the hole!
Hicks has got the distance right.
And the thing that is happening for Fowler, and when that happens, his gallery knows that they've seen that special putting stroke through the years, and it's returning.
So smooth, he
landed. Can land it around the front. Even the wind is out of the right, and if it'll straighten it up enough. Oh, it just did. Boy, that's a good break. Just carried that heavy fescue, and that's just fine.
What a difference.
This is a challenge for sure.
This is lacking some enthusiasm here, Kurt.
Yeah, it sure is. He's got a lot of work left if he wants to stay at 11 under par.
He's probably a little scared of what you were talking about, rolling a little past the left.
Rickie Fowler for that par.
No three putts this week.
Left it short again. What are you
doing? How about that reaction?
To the holes. What do you want me to do? I'm leading.
Fowler on the tee and Smiley trouble yesterday. How about today?
Well, it started out towards that Barranca. It's going to need a lucky bounce.
He hit it right into the Barranca yesterday. And it looks like it went in.
Maybe he can hit a knuckle runner here.
Oh, it's coming in hot. Just needs a big bounce.
Look at that thing go.
That was an 8-iron from 228. Almost got to the front of the green.
It nosedived, didn't it?
Game has been dialed in. Let's see what the short game looks like right here with his third at the par five.
I would give that probably a B plus.
Oh, the putter bailing out again. That's birdie number 15 this week. Hasn't even made the turn yet in the second round.
Rickie has really earned it through dedication.
It's a low-flighted 6-iron towards the middle of the green.
Yeah, that's a good shot. He felt like he had to flight it because of the amount of wind. And that is about as perfect, probably, to his aim.
Up and over the hill. Close to his 16th birdie at his championship.
My goodness, what a putt.
And that's what made Rickie so good, knocking on the door. It'll
be a blind second shot. If he can put it on the fairway, usually roll to the left.
Low and cutting towards that bunker.
He doesn't want to reach it. If you're going to bring the bunkers into play, you might as well hit driver or just take them out of play. So this was a kind of a tactical error as well as an execution mistake, but he's put himself in a spot here where he maybe can still save par.
Bringing it in nice and low, just right of it.
Yeah, that's right where he was aiming. He needed to get a few more yards, maybe three more yards out of that.
So it's another bogey for Fowler. What did the USGA's John Bodenhammer tell us at the meeting? He said the standard bears are going to be busy this week. Could be a lot of bogeys, a lot of birdies.
See if he makes a correction.
Yeah, you want to miss short left and let the slope carry this ball onto the green.
One of the better swings of the day, right at it.
should release, but lands in front, and it does. Big bounce. Really good shot. 297 to the hole today.
Right up the hill.
211.
And Fowler from just off the green. Need some downhill right here.
All right, running out over a lot of time. At the tough par 3 11th, it's a 297-yard par 3. Had that for par. So again, one step forward, one step back, and that is Fowler's fourth bogey of the day. So he fell back to 9 under, and now we've got three tied for the lead. The 62 boys from yesterday and Wyndham Clark.
Rickie's missed his last two fairways on 8 and 10. This one's a must fairway to get it close to the hole. Looks like he likes it quick to the tee. This whole location on this short par 4 is just on the front right. If you're not in the fairway, impossible to get it close. But that's, and this whole location's on the fingernail of that finger, just on the tip.
Starting out well to the left, cutting it on a pretty good line.
Back for Fowler after first time making consecutive bogeys here at LA Country Club. Rights the ship with a birdie on the 12th. Steak sauce. Yes. Loudest roar we've heard a long time. Rickie Fowler with birdie here on 12.
On a very nice line up the left side. This should stay in the fairway.
Yeah, this area he's trying to land it is about 15 yards wide, so that's a super shot. That is a small little area on this massive fairway. A long way back, 227 left to right, wind here. Good straight bounce. This will stay on the green. He's going to putt. Weird looking ball flight. See what the strike was. Yeah, a little crashy, kind of maybe got a hair steep on it, but it, not a bad shot.
And he didn't give that near enough of a hit.
Oh. Moving to his right. Knows he can be aggressive with it.
Instead, it's another step back.
Another three putt.
Talked earlier, Zing, about the standard bears here getting a workout here. Because you can make birdies here in a hurry, but you can also take a step back.
Wind off the right. Can he carry that bunker? Just about 305 to carry. Might be left. Yep, got the downslope. That's a big drive for Fowler.
So this hole location, Rickie said, he was probably going to lay up to about that 123 front head.
Well, that was a pretty lofted club, so obviously going to stay well back.
Well, you know, you would think, Brad, that the greenside bunker would be a good place to be, but it's really not.
110 yards.
Should be a perfect yardage for a spinny wedge.
Looks pretty good.
It's really good. Well played hole. Yeah, take a look here. And Zing, you talked about his weight shift. All the weight's on his left side now. Down on it. Keeps turning through. Recocks the club up.
He's always.
We'll stay up. Just need a little bit more speed going back up that hill.
Go back to 15 for Fowler.
Very quick to play. Get the
ball! Oh, yeah. Rickie is dialed in. With his wedge game, that's for sure.
It's a pretty good place to watch some golf, Zing. Fine little hole.
And a lot going on all around this little area. Look at him use the slope and bring that back. That's really how you're supposed to do it. Where Jason Day is.
Fowler not wasting any time over at 15 to get to 10 under.
Just outside the right edge.
Yeah. Another one.
This guy is a birdie machine. That's all you can say.
He had the most birdies in a U.S. Open round in history yesterday with 10. He's now got a total of 17.
It's a certain mindset that allows a player to make putts like this. Yeah. For birdie. This is really something. Yeah. Rickie Fowler this week, the energy around him.
They've loved him for a long time, right, Zing?
Yeah.
He has been 555, plays downhill. If he goes in that bunker left, it usually means bogey. Very few players have been able to. That is left of it. Let's see what the lie looks like. Aiming way right. This is going to be ride the wind, Smiley.
Yep, ball above his feet. This is on a needs to get up over that bunker.
He had to play way out to the right. Hope it came back with the hook and the wind helping it. And it just never quite took off.
When the ball's above your feet, Kurt, you hit it way shorter. And he needed the 7-iron. This is one of the hardest shots in all of golf.
It was sitting on the upslope, which didn't help him in this case. He needed to go a long way. The flag stick is 33 steps from the front edge, plus there's room between the bunker. Looked at that one like he may have hit something in there. Yeah, outside 52 feet.
There's a ton of right to left in this, Kurt.
Enough spin to pull it back down that hill.
This is 16. And Fowler just cleaning up his bogey. So all three players bogeyed in that group.
Rickie in the throes of this huge par four finish.
Yeah, huge in many ways. 530 yards. The wind's blowing off the right, so it's helping the golfer to not go in that barranca that goes all the way down the right side. And there's a great start here on this hole.
We go to Fowler at 17.
Yeah, the hardest par four on the golf course today. Only 20%, 21% of the players have hit the green in regulation, and that's a high draw. That's looking good. Using the slope. What a shot by Rickie Fowler. Chance for a birdie.
Now just at the end.
Sole possession of the lead. What a read, Smiley. What a putt, Rickie. 10 under for Fowler.
The 62s yesterday, first one ever, and then it's just a crazy type day for Fowler.
And on the left, then change their mind. So that Bermuda grass, it's thick and it's kind of weak.
Yeah.
That looks pretty good.
Should catch a piece.
Yeah, that's a terrific start to this demanding hole.
Left side of the fairway, good angle from 201.
Big, big break!
On a pretty good line, just right of it.
Oh. Beautiful shot. Players have ever posted double digit after 36 holes, and they both went on to win.
Is it going to be Fowler's weekend at this U.S. Open?
And when you're confident, you're confident. Just for short range, you just ran this thing in. Leader is with Damon.
Thank you, Dan. Rickie, a much different test today than yesterday. How did this golf course evolve from Thursday to Friday?
Yeah, it was a little firmer green-wise, and then pins were maybe tucked a little more, and then on a little bit more slope. So I actually felt, you probably saw it, I left a number of putts short. I felt like they were a bit slow, and also I was, hitting up, some pretty good slopes. I was struggling to get myself to hit it hard enough because you really don't want the other ones coming back if you hammer it by. But I would say that was kind of the two big things, pins. Like I said, a little bit more tucked on some more slope, and then just felt like greens are a little slower.
look at some highlights. 18 birdies through 36 holes. A third shot at the par 5 first.
Yeah, I was sneaky close to that lip. Awkward stance, and we're just making sure I got that thing up.
Fantastic bunker shot. How about your second at 2? This is from 175 yards.
I had a nice number. It was just a good 8-iron and hold it up against that left-to-right wind. I've been swinging well, so just had to trust it and go right at it.
You hit that one stiff, and you kept it going with your second at the 3rd.
Yeah, again, I had a nice kind of 5-off wedge number with gap wedge. Kind of tried to let it ride the wind, cut in there. Again, hit my number, so definitely nice to get off to a good start like that.
And the flat stick's been a big part of the story. How about the birdie at 8, a little right to lefter?
Yeah, 8, you know, I was in the right rough, gave myself a chance to go up and down there. And I'm trying not to get too cute with it, gave myself a good look.
Here at 12, how much has the putter felt like the old days?
Yeah, it's definitely been nice. Like I said, other than some of those speed putts from long range with the greens, that, like I said, felt a little slower, but that was a bonus there with that front pin on 12.
Tee shot at 15, which will lead to the 7th birdie of the day.
This was a nice number with sand wedge. You know, it was really just commit and trust it. You know, down off the left, and just try to hit solid and stay committed to it.
How crispy are the greens getting?
They're still, you know, receptive with short irons from the fairway. This might be up there as one of the best shots of the last 2 days. Did exactly what I was trying to do. It landed it on basically a little doormat that I wanted to. And that one was nice the way it did.
8 birdies on a Friday at the U.S. Open. Rickie, you've been very steady in good times and bad. I'm curious what you've learned about yourself through adversity.
Been a lot in the last 3 years. It's more getting back to playing golf and knowing what I'm capable of versus those last few years. It was kind of let's see what we got and go find out. So I know what I can do. Obviously plenty of offense the last 2 days, and this course does allow for that, but at the same time you get out of position, there's plenty of other stuff that can happen. So trying to stay disciplined. And I think that's also been a big part of this last, you know, 6 to 10 months, the management. And when I do get out of position, kind of salvaging what I can and continuing to move forward.
Get some rest. We'll see you tomorrow.
Thank you.